Bismillah, alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salam ala rasulillah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Questions from last week. So have your books closed, please. We spoke about sujood al-tilawa last week, and the imam, he mentioned how many are there? 14, very good. What's the difference, we said, between the sami' and the mustami' when it comes to sujood al-tilawa? Yeah, which one? The mustami' is the one who is intending to listen, and the sami' is the one who is not intending to listen. Okay? So why does the mustami' make sujood with the imam? Good, but what's the reasoning we gave why he makes sujood with the imam? He shares the reward, right? Via his intention to listen, therefore he must share in the sujood at-tilawa also. When you make Salat al-Istisqa, the imam, he mentioned that you turn your clothing inside out, your outer garments. Why do you do that? A symbol of hope, tafa'ul, exactly, that Allah would change the state from the state of drought to a state whereby the rain will descend and benefit the Muslims. What is the difference, we said, between the two words, Salat al-Kusuf and Salat al-Khusuf? What are they? Yeah, which one?
Khusuf is for the sun.
Very good, yes. And Khusuf is for the moon. And we said they can also be interchangeable as well, right? They can be interchangeable. How do you pray that prayer? Okay. Okay. Four ruku and how many sujood?
Four.
Four sujood. What else should be done in that prayer? What's are the surahs? Are they to be short or are they to be long?
The first, long. Fatiha and then long surah.
Very good.
And Fatiha and short surah.
So shorter than the one before. Very good. Exactly. And what kind of verses should the imam talk about in the khutbah? Istighfar, right? What was the connection between istighfar and seeking rain?
Verses
in Surah An-Nuh. Because istighfar, seeking forgiveness from Allah Azza wa Jal, is a sure means of gaining provision. And from the greatest of provisions is the descending of rain upon the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Zakum Allah khair. So we continue what the Imam is saying, and he mentions today Babu Sa'at Allati Nuhiya an As-Salah Fiha. He's going to talk about the times wherein the prayer is forbidden to be prayed in those times. What's forbidden to be prayed in those times? The prayer. Which prayer? The nawafil, right? Not the obligatory. So we're talking about the nawafil prayers here, the tatawwa, the extra, what's this word? That word, supererogatory prayer in the forbidden times. Tayyib. So the imam, he says the first of them, بعد الفجر حتى تطلع الشمس. After fajr, until the sun rises. What does he mean after fajr? Does he mean the time of fajr or does he mean the prayer of fajr? The prayer of Fajr. So the ulama here, they have a difference of opinion. We have the hadith in Bukhari and Muslim of Abi Sa'id al-Khudri, where the Prophet radiyallahu anhu, where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا صلاة بعد العصر حتى تغرب الشمس. There's no prayer after Salat al-Asr until the sun has set. ولا صلاة بعد الفجر حتى تطلع الشمس. And there's no prayer after Fajr, excuse me, until the sun has risen. So based upon this hadith, it's understood by the Hanbali scholars and the Hanafi that there should be no prayer between the Adhan and the Iqama, right? No prayer between the Adhan and the Iqama. That's incorrect, isn't it? This is the opinion of the Shafi'i, a narration from Imam Ahmad. Okay? So in any case, our Imam, he's saying that after you've prayed Salat al-Fajr, there's no other prayer. Tayyib? The Hanbali scholars and the Hanafi scholars, they say after the Adhan of Fajr is in fact when the prohibition starts. Okay? You cannot even pray something after the Adhan of Fajr except for the Sunnah of Fajr and then of course the obligatory prayer of Fajr. So there's no other tatawwa in between the Adhan, okay, and the Iqama. What they base this upon is the hadith in Tirmidhi and Abu Dawood where the Prophet said, لا تصلوا بعد صلاة الفجر إلا ركعتي الفجر. Do not pray after Fajr, meaning the Adhan of Fajr, except for the two Sunnah, إلا ركعتي الفجر, except for the two Sunnah of Fajr. And this is in Tirmidhi and Abu Dawood. Raqat al-Fajr, Sunnah, after the Adhan al-Fajr. According to this opinion of the Hanbali scholars and the Hanafi scholars, Imam Shafi rahimahullah ta'ala, and one narration from Imam Ahmad, they allow prayers between the Adhan and the Iqama. Why? They say the hadith which we quoted just before of Abi Sa'id al-Khudri, okay? They said the mafhum al-mukhalafa of that, mafhum al-mukhalafa means the opposite understanding. Because the hadith of Abi Sa'id al-Khudri, it said after the prayer of Fajr, there is no prayer. So, لا صلاة بعد الفجر حتى تطلع الشمس. There's no prayer after the Fajr until the sun has risen. So the مفهوم المخالفة, which means the opposite understanding, is that obviously before then, prayer is allowed. So based upon that understanding, Imam Shafi and some of the scholars, they allowed the prayer between the Adhan and the Iqamah. Apart from the two rak'ah of Sunnah al-Fajr we are talking about. And also they have a hadith in Sahih Muslim where the Prophet ﷺ said, صَلِّ صَلَاتُ الصُّبْحِ ثُمَّ أَقْصِرْ عَنِ الصَّلَاةِ حَتَّى تَطْلَعَ الشَّمْسِ. Pray the subh prayer, okay, the Fajr prayer, and then abstain from the prayer until the sun has risen. So in this hadith in Sahih Muslim, it's clearly stating that the forbidden time starts when? After you've prayed Salat al-Fajr. Okay, so in any case, what the Imam is telling us, without the extra information that I gave, is that once you have prayed Fajr Salah, there is no prayer after Fajr Salah until when? Until the sun has risen. So this is the first time he gives. The second time he gives, he says, وَبَعْدَ طُلُوئِهَا حَتَّى تَرْتَفِعَ قِيدَ رُمْحِ. And after the sun has risen,
doesn't he give the exception of if you missed your sunnah?
We're going to come to this, inshallah. We come, Zakallah khair. So then the Imam, he says, after the Salah has risen, okay, حَتَّى قِيدَ الرُّمْحِ. قِيدَ الرُّمْحِ, we have to understand, it means measurement of a spear. Okay, measurement of a spear. So he said, بَعْدَ طُلُوئِهَا حَتَّى تَرْتَفِعَ قِيدَ الرُّمْحِ. So the first time we said, after the prayer of Fajr, until the sun has risen. Now he's saying, until the sun has risen, okay, the level of a spear, which is basically one like a meter above the horizon. When the sun rises from view of the eye, a meter above the horizon, okay? And this is roughly 15 minutes after sunrise. Sheikh Uthaymeen Sharh al-Mumti', he said it's generally around 15 minutes period of time after sunrise. Taib, so this is also a time when you cannot pray. Why did the ulama make this time into two times? Because in reality, it's how many times? It's one time. After sunrise, right? You could have just said after sunrise. But they made it into two times because this second time is ashad. It's more severe in its prohibition. Because this is the time when the sun rises between the two horns of shaitan, as mentioned in some ahadith, and the people, the kuffar, the worshippers of shaitan, they would prostrate in that time. So this time is more severe. That's why the ulama, they separated the two times. But if you wanted to simplify, as we will come to later on, you can add them as one time. After you've prayed Salat al-Fajr, until the sun has risen, okay? That's when, after this time, 15 minutes or so after sunrise, you could start to pray the voluntary prayers. For example, which voluntary prayer would you pray after that? Salat al-Duha, okay? Salat al-Duha, if you wanted to. And we'll talk about this towards the end of the lesson as one of the brothers reminded me and asked me to do so. وَإِنْدَ قِيَامِهَا حَتَّى تَزُولُ. The Imam, he says now the third time. وَإِنْدَ قِيَامِهَا حَتَّى تَزُولُ. What does this mean? إِنْدَ قِيَامِهَا, meaning that the sun now is directly above you. The sun now is in the middle of the sky, the highest it can be. And the ulama, they say that this time is roughly for about 5 minutes. But Shaykh Uthaymeen in Sharh al-Mumtah rahimullah, he said on the safe side, take it for 15 minutes. So when the sun is in the middle of the sky, before it starts to move, before it starts to make the zawal, okay? Before the time of dhuhr, basically. So 15 minutes or so before the time of dhuhr is also a forbidden time for you to pray. Now some of the ulama, they made an exception. What do you think the exception is? No. That is another exception, good. But we'll come to that. Which day can you pray the prayer here? Salatul Jummah, right? When you come, Salatul Jummah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, for example, in Sahih al-Bukhari, when he was talking about the virtues of the one who goes to Salatul Jummah, and he says, if you get there early and you made wudu, you get such and such rewards. And then he said, فَصَلَّ مَا كُتِبَ لَهُ. And then the person gets up and he prays whatever he wants to pray from nawafil. Here the Prophet ﷺ didn't make any istithna. He didn't make any distinction in a time where you shouldn't pray. He just left it open, mutlaq, that the person in the time of Jummah, on the day of Jummah, once he comes to the masjid, he can pray whatever he wishes to pray. So here, this is used as a proof that on the day of Jummah, this forbidden time, which is 10 minutes or 15 minutes before dhuhr, doesn't apply. And also Imam Malik in his Muwatta, he narrated that the companions radiallahu anhum, كان الناس يصلون قبل الخطبة أو قبل الجمعة في زمن عمر رضي الله عنه حتى يقوم الخطيب. That the people in the time of Umar رضي الله عنه, as narrated by Imam Malik, that they would pray whatever they wanted to pray until the khatib would get onto the minbar. So this also shows you that the companions understood that the istithna to this forbidden time, the exception was Jumma. طيب. So what have we taken so far? How many times have we taken so far, just as a recap? Huh? Three, right? We took from after you've prayed Salat al-Fajr until the sun has risen. And then 15 minutes after the sun rises. And the third one? When the sun is in the middle of the sky for between 5 to 15 minutes, okay? So this is the three times that we've taken so far. Then the Imam, he says, Rahimullah Ta'ala, وَبَعْضَ الْأَصَرْ حَتَّى تَتَضَيِّفَ الشَّمْسْ لِغُرُوبِ. Once you've prayed Salat al-Asr, and when the sun starts to weaken in its color, before the sunset, okay, or for the sunset, moving towards the sunset. So once you've prayed Salat al-Asr, then after that time, it also becomes forbidden for you to pray. What if you've prayed Asr with Dhuhr? If you made Jam' Taqdeem here. If you prayed Salat al-Asr with Dhuhr, what do you do in that situation? It's the same principle, right? Because it's attached to the prayer of Salat al-Asr. The Imam, he says, وَإِذَا تَضَيَّفَتْ حَتَّى تَغْرُبْ. So after the prayer of Asr, and also for 5 or 15 minutes before the sun actually sets. Like again, the first time is divided into two, because this time, before the sun actually sets, for 5 to 15 minutes, is again another extra stress time. Again, where the sun would set between the horns of shaitan. The first one, the sun would rise between the horns of shaitan. Here, it's setting between the horns of shaitan. Therefore, the tahrim here is a shad. It's more strict this time. That's why the ulama divided it. So what are the 5 times that we mentioned? Starting again from the beginning, just so it's clear in everyone's head. Somebody tell me the first time. After Salat al-Fajr, right? Then? 15 minutes, okay, after sunrise. Then? The sun is in the middle of the sky, and that last we said 5 to 15 minutes, okay? The fourth time? After Salat al-Asr. The fifth time? Before Maghrib, before 15 minutes or so before the sun actually sets, okay? طيب. So that's clear. Before the sunset? What? Say that again, please. What do you mean?
Could it also come as before Maghrib?
It is before Maghrib. So the time after Salat al-Asr all the way up until Maghrib. So now we've got the 5 times Who can make them into three times? And this will make it clear for the young brother. Make him into three times. After Salat al-Fajr, until the sun has risen for 15 minutes. This is one time. The second time, when the sun is in the middle of the sky. The third time, after Salat al-Asr, until the sun sets. Does that make it clear for you? After Salat al-Asr, until the sun sets, you cannot pray in that time. طيب, who can make, according to what we mentioned, according to some of the ulama, make the time six? Who can make, according to one of the opinions we mentioned, make it six times?
And you add in the time between sunnah, fajr time, sunnah and...
Very good. So we said the sixth time, if you wanted to add it, is between the adhan of fajr and the prayer of fajr. The only exception there is raqat al-fajr, the sunnah. Okay, but the other tatawwa cannot be done in that time. So if you wanted to add that, you could make it six times. Jazakallah khair. طيب, so the imam, he says, فهذه ساعات لا يصلي فيها تطوعا. That in these times you cannot pray the supererogatory prayers at all in these times. Okay? Now some of the ulama, like Imam Shafi rahimahullah ta'ala, he said تطوع المقيد can be prayed in this time. For example, salawat ذاتul asbab, they call them. Okay? Prayers which have a cause for them to be prayed. For example, Tahiyyat al-Masjid. Okay, when you come to the Masjid in a forbidden time, you can pray. Why? Because the Prophet ﷺ said in the Hadith, إِذَا دَخْلَ أَحْدُكُمُ الْمَسْجِدْ فَلَا يَجْلِسْ حَتَّى يُصَلِّيَ رَكَعَتَيْنِ. If one of you comes to the Masjid, then do not sit down until he prays two rak'ah. So the ulama, they say that this Hadith is from Dhatul Asbab. It's from the supererogatory prayers that have a reason for it. Okay. Therefore, you can do it at any time of the day, okay? Whether it's forbidden or not. From this, they say, for example, Salatul Istikhara. From this, they say, for example, the two rak'ah that you pray after wudu. Okay, so these are some exceptions that they allow for you to pray in the forbidden times. طيب. Imam Ibn Qudamah rahimahullah ta'ala, he's going to now mention some exceptions of his own. From the forbidden times that we mentioned, prayers that can be mentioned. The first of them, he says, إِلَّا إِعَادَةِ الْجَمَاءِ إِذَا أُقِيمَتْ وَهُوَ فِي الْمَسْجِدِ. Except for the repetition of a congregation that takes place in the masjid. What does this mean? Say for example, you've prayed Salatul Fajr in the masjid, right? And then you sit down, you start making your adhkar. Then another jama'ah comes along and they start to pray. Now in this situation, you can get up and you can pray with them. And for you, it will be nafil. So here it's an exception. Why? Because you prayed Salat al-Fajr and now another jama'ah has taken place. You didn't intend to pray with that jama'ah, but it happened in front of you, so you can get up and pray with them. Why? Because the Prophet ﷺ said in Abi Dawood and Tirmidhi to two men that he saw in the masjid that were sitting down while they were praying. He said to them, مَا مَنَأَكُمَا أَن تُصَلِّيَ مَعَنَا. He said, what prevented you two from praying with us? قَالَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ قَدْ صَلَيْنَا فِي رَحَالِنَا. They said, O Prophet of Allah, we prayed in our dwellings. He said, فَلَا تَفْعَلَ. He said, don't do so. إِذَا صَلَيْتُمَا فِي رِحَالِكُمَا ثُمَّ أَتَيْتُمَا مَسْجِدَ جَمَاعَةٍ فَصَلِّيَا مَعَهُمْ تَكُنْ لَكُمْ نَافِلًا. He said, if you have prayed in your dwellings, the Prophet ﷺ is saying to these two men, and then you come to the masjid where the jama'ah is being held, where the congregation is being held, then pray with them and it will be for you a nafil prayer, an extra nafil prayer. So here is the first exception. Okay? But understand that you cannot intend to do that. It's if it just takes place in front of you. So now, if you've prayed Fajr, you cannot go to another masjid now intending to pray Salat al-Fajr again, a second time, right? It's just that you happen to be in the masjid, you've gone there for whatever reason, and a jama'ah takes place in front of you. In that situation, you can get up and you can pray with them. طيب. The Imam, he says also, وَرَكَعْتَ الطَّوَافْ بَعْدَهُ. Also, the two rak'ah that you do after making the tawaf, you can also pray this in any of the five forbidden times. The first one that we mentioned, when you have a repetition of the Salat al-Jama'ah, this is in any of the five forbidden times. Likewise, this one also. The two rak'ah that you can do after the tawaf is also in any of the five forbidden times. Why? Because the Prophet ﷺ said, as narrated by Imam Ahmad, يَا بَنِي أَبْدِ مَنَافِ لَا تَمْنُوا أَحَدًا طَافَ بِهَذَا الْبَيْتِ وَصَلَّى فِي أَيَّ سَعَةٍ شَاءٍ مِنْ لَيْلٍ أَوْ نَهَارٍ. O Bani Abdul Manaf, do not prevent anybody making tawaf of the Kaaba and praying in any time of the day and night. In any time of the day and night. What's the key word here? In any time. Again, so this makes it an exception from the five times which were prohibited, okay? So if you make the rak'at al-tawaf, okay, then you can do that in any of the forbidden times. The imam, he says, wa salat ala janaza. And also exempt from the forbidden times is the salat upon the janaza. But this is not in the five times, it's in the two times. Which two times do you think? The two long times. What are the two long times? After Fajr and after Asr. These are the long times. Why do the ulama they say this? They say because if you delay the Salatul Janazah in the long times, the body can become decomposed in those countries that do not have refrigerators, etc. But the short times, like for example, when the sun is at its meridian, it only takes around 5 to 15 minutes. So waiting for that short time is not a problem, okay? So they say here the exception is only in the two long times, not in the five times. Whereas the first two exceptions we mentioned are in all of the five times. But this exception is only in the two long times. With me? وَقَضَعْ سُنَنْ الرَّوَاتِبْ فِي وَقْتَيْن مِنْهَا. And to make up the rawatib, the sunan al-rawatib, in the two times which he will mention. وَهُمَّ بَعْدَ الْفَجْرِ وَبَعْدَ الْأَصْرِ. What is sunan al-rawatib? How do we define sunan al-rawatib? They are the ones that are attached to the obligatory prayers, athabit al-mustamir. Okay? The ones that the Prophet ﷺ would do regularly, like? Huh? The two before Fajr, the four before Dhuhr, the two after Dhuhr, etc., etc. Okay? So these ones, the Imam, he's saying you can make them up if you're in the situation where you have to make them up after Fajr and after Asr. Tayyib? Then the Imam, he says, وَيَجُوزْ قَضَاءَ الْمَفْرُوضَاتِ فِي جَمِيعِ الْأَوْقَاتِ. He says, with regards to the obligatory prayers, you can make these up in any time whatsoever. Why? Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith in Bukhari and Muslim, إِذَا نَامَ أَحَدُكَ أَنِ الصَّلَاةِ أَوْ نَسْيَهَا فَلْيُسَلِّيهَا إِذَا ذَكْرَهَا لَا كَفَارَ لَهَا إِلَّا ذَلِكَ. If one of you prays, no, if one of you sleeps over the time of prayer or forgets to pray it, then he should pray it as soon as he remembers it. There is no kafara, no expiation for that prayer except to do that. So as soon as you remember the prayer or as soon as you wake up, whatever time of day you are in, that's when you should make that prayer up, okay? The obligatory prayer, that's when you should make it up. But you have, now.
Isn't there a saying also that you should change the location, so you shouldn't pray in the same place when you're speaking?
This is based upon, yes, one of the narrations where the Prophet ﷺ did that when he slept in the valley and he moved on from that. But as a qa'idah, I don't know. If that's what you're supposed to do. If you've slept in a place and you overslept and you missed a prayer, are you supposed to move from that place and then pray? I don't know. Allah knows best. Tayyib, when we make this qadha, okay, salatul qadha, it's not something that we should take lightly, okay? What's the ayah? Inna salah kanat al-mu'mineen kitabun mawquta, okay? So these prayers are in specific times. You cannot decide to just make them up or delay them as you wish. It's a serious sin to do so. The only time you can make them up, okay, in reality, is if you had a valid excuse to miss them in the first place. Otherwise, there is the opinion there that if you miss the prayer without valid excuse, even if you were to pray it 1,000 times, you will not get that prayer made up. Why? Because of the hadith of Aisha radiallahu anha, where the Prophet ﷺ said, مَنْ أَحْدَثَ فِي أَمْرِنَا هَذَا مَا لَيْسَ مِنْهُ فَهُوَ رَدْ. So to do a prayer outside of its time without valid excuse is like making an innovation. Okay, so no matter how many times you do it, you're not going to get the reward. But the majority of the ulama, they said, even if you did it in that situation, then you should make it up. Even if you did it in that situation, then you need to make it up. طيب, but what do you do? How do you make up the qada? How do you make up the salawat? What is the way of making them up? Murattaban, tartib, okay? Like we said in the verse, that the prayers are in fixed times. So you have to make them up in fixed times, okay? Because like the ulama, they said, al-qada yahki al-ada. When you make up the qada, it's done in the way that the normal prayers are done. Okay, so you have to do it in the normal manner like the brother is saying. Say for example, it's time for you now to play, you miss Salat al-Dhuhr. But now in the masjid, Salat al-Asr is being established. The iqama for Salat al-Asr is taking place. So according to the majority opinion, you do not now come to Salat al-Asr and say, I'm going to have the intention to pray Salat al-Dhuhr behind the imam and then make up Asr. This is not what you are supposed to do according to the majority. Though Shaykh Uthaymeen rahimahullah ta'ala and others like that, they said you can have that intention. Why are we saying this? Because we're saying that the prayers are upon fixed times. And according to the aqaida that I gave you, al-qada yahki al-ada. That when you make the qada, it's done in the same way that you would make the normal prayers up. And based upon that rule that I mentioned also, as Muhammad Muqtar al-Shinqiti hafidullah mentioned in his explanation, that if you were to pray, for example, the sunnah of Fajr, which is your normal habit, you missed it for whatever reason, and you were to pray it after Fajr, it should be done in the same manner that you normally do, which is that you should pray it quickly. The sunnah to Fajr is generally that you should pray it quickly. So even when you make up that sunnah, you do it in the normal manner, which is to pray it quickly. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. Just to touch upon Salat al-Duha, as it was mentioned, that we would do so. Just hold the question. We'll just touch upon this and come to questions, inshallah. Salat al-Duha, the Prophet ﷺ said in many narrations the virtues of this salah. For example, in the hadith in Sahih Muslim, Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, he said, Awsani al-Khalil bi-thalaf, that my beloved, Khalil is somebody, as you know, that you love and that you are very close to. He said, my beloved, meaning the Prophet ﷺ, advised me with three things. La ada'uhunna hatta amut. Abu Hurairah said, I'm not going to leave them until I die. One of them, from the three, was to pray 3 days, to fast 3 days a month. The second of them was to pray Salat al-Duha. And the third of them was to sleep after having done witr. Okay? So in this hadith, it's from the wasiyah of the Prophet ﷺ to those who he loves, that they should pray Salat al-Duha. In another narration, the Prophet ﷺ said that every son of Adam, he wakes up every day and it's incumbent upon him to give charity for every bone in his body. And he mentions towards the end of the hadith that what will suffice you for doing that is to pray 2 raka'at of Salat al-Duha. طيب, when does the time for Salat al-Duha start? 15 minutes or 10 minutes after the Shuruq al-Shams, after the sun has risen, until 15 minutes or so before the Salat al-Duhar. What is the minimum and what is the maximum that you can pray? Minimum is 2 and the maximum, according to many, is 8. Otherwise, many, they say 12, and sometimes there's no limit. But the majority, they say 8. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. Can you pray in congregation? No, you should not pray in congregation. Tayyib. Wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Anything which was correct was from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Any shortcomings and mistakes were from myself and shaitan. If you have any questions or clarifications, please feel free.